Hello students, welcome to English learning session. Students, do you enjoy stories? If you love stories, then you are going to love today's session too, because today we are going to enjoy and study a story. But before I introduce the session, I want to ask you a small question. The question is, look at these pictures on the screen and try to identify the pictures. Have you ever seen these pictures in your real life or this animal? Notice in the first picture how the color of this animal matches with the stick branch, and here the color matches with the leaves. Oh yes, I hope you have guessed. In the mother tongue it's called Girgit, and in English it's chameleon. The word is, repeat after me, it's chameleon. Chameleon is an animal that changes color according to the surrounding. But in our story, we are not going to read about chameleon. You must be wondering, ma'am is going to give a lesson on biology? No, no, no. We are going to read a story about a person. This is the second meaning. It's written, a person whose behavior changes according to the situation. So, our story is A Chameleon from your book, A Rainbow of English, Section C, Extensive Reading. Story, A Chameleon, written by Anton Chekhov. What is extensive reading, students? You must understand the difference between these two. Extensive reading can essentially also be referred to as reading for joy. Please understand this. It is reading for joy. Enjoy karandele. This approach advocates reading as much material in your target language as humanly possible. This way, you will be exposed to the widest range of vocabulary and grammatical structures. All of this will make you a better language learner and help you on the way to fluency. So students, isa matlab ki hai ki you should read as many stories in the target language. Here the target language is English. Try to read as many stories, as many articles in English as you can, and as you read, you will see that your vocabulary will grow and you will become more fluent in the language. And here, enjoying is the key word. You must enjoy the story. So, here is an introduction to today's interesting story. The chameleon, as we just discussed, is a very popular type of lizard. It has the ability to change color based on its mood or surroundings. But in our story, the attitude of the police superintendent Oshumalov. Now this is a Russian name and the pronunciation can vary. Some call this Oshumalov or Oshumalov. I'll be pronouncing it as Oshumalov. So you can see in the picture, there is a police superintendent. His name is Oshumalov. In this story, the attitude of the police superintendent Oshumalov is compared with the chameleon. He changes his attitude depending on the situation. But let's get to know the author first. Anton Chekhov was born on January 29, 1860 in Taganrog, Russia. He is the master of modern short story. Chekhov had at first written stories to earn money, but As his artistic ambition grew, he made formal innovations which have influenced the evolution of the modern short story. So, he is considered as the master of short stories. Now, before we read the lesson, we must get familiar with some of the words that we are going to read in the story. That will help us in understanding the story. The first word is strides. Strides. That is, walk with long steps in a specified direction. And it's very much clear in the picture itself. Confiscated. Confiscated. Officially taken away from a lawbreaker as a punishment. Kanuni torte kise to us di cheez nu hadap lena le lena. Disconsolate. Unhappy and disappointed. Yelping. Crying in pain. Sleeping countenances, that is sleepy faces. When a person gets up from the sleep and the expression on that face, then we call the person, the face, as sleeping countenances. Protruded, in the story it means come out. Students, one word has many meanings and the meaning of a word changes according to the context. So we should always try to understand the meaning on the basis of the context. Timber yard. It's a small enclosed area with logs of wood. You must have seen these timber yards in your area. No rhyme or reason means with no logical reason, without any reason. Bina kise karan to, no rhyme or reason. Gooseberries. Gooseberries are a round, edible, yellowish green fruit. Ek phal da naam hai. Gooseberry. Sieve. A utensil consisting of a wire or plastic mesh held in a frame. You must have recognized this. It's very much present in your kitchens too. Goldsmith, a person who makes gold articles. Sunyar. Row. Again, it has two meanings, a queue and a noisy quarrel. Ek line, as you can see in the picture, or chagda, row. A blackguard. It has again many meanings, a devil, a villain, or as in this story, a dishonest person with no sense of what is right or wrong. Blockhead, a stupid person, as you can see in the picture. A person is cutting the wood, cutting the branch, and he himself is sitting on the same branch. The person is stupid. So blockhead is a stupid person. Hind, at the back. As you can see in the picture, the dog is standing on its hind legs. Hind legs, back legs. Muzzle, the projecting part of the face, including the nose and mouth of an animal such as a dog or a horse. So in the picture, this version is the muzzle. We pronounce it as muzzle. Strangled, killed by squeezing the throat. Now in the picture, the man is, what is he doing? He's strangling the lady. To kill by squeezing the throat. Swine is a pig, but it is also an unpleasant, foolish person. This is the meaning in the story. An unpleasant, foolish person. Thoroughbred, a pure breed. Nasal, as in the picture, it's about the horse, but in our story, it is a dog. So students, let's read the story, let's enjoy it, and then we'll discuss after reading the story. Now you have to read with me. The police superintendent Osho Malov is walking across the market square wearing a new overcoat and carrying a parcel under his arm. A red-haired policeman strides after him with a sieve full of confiscated gooseberries in his hands. There is silence all around. Not a soul in the square. The open doors of the shops and taverns look out upon God's world disconsolately, like hungry mouths. There's not even a beggar near them. "So you bite, you damned brute!" Otomailov hears suddenly. "Lads, don't let him go. Biting is prohibited nowadays. Hold him, ah, ah!" There is the sound of a dog yelping. Otomailov looks in the direction of the sound and sees a dog hopping on three legs and looking about her, run out of Pichugin's timber yard. A man in a starched cotton shirt with his waistcoat unbuttoned is chasing her. He runs after her and, throwing his body forward, falls down and seizes the dog by her hind legs. Once more there is a yelping and a shout of, "Don't let go!" Sleepy countenances are protruded from the shops, and soon a crowd, which seems to have sprung out of the earth, is gathered round the timber yard. "It looks like a row, Your Honor," says the policeman. Otomailov makes a half turn to the left and strides towards the crowd. He sees the aforementioned man in the unbuttoned waistcoat standing close by the gate of the timber yard, holding his right hand in the air and displaying a bleeding finger to the crowd. On his half-drunken face there is plainly written, "I'll pay you out, you rogue." And indeed, the very finger has the look of a flag of victory. In this man, Otomailov recognizes Ryukin, the goldsmith. The culprit who has caused the sensation, a white puppy with a sharp muzzle and a yellow patch on her back, is sitting on the ground with her forepaws outstretched in the middle of the crowd, trembling all over. There is an expression of misery and terror in her tearful eyes. "What's it all about?" Otomailov inquires, pushing his way through the crowd. "What are you here for? Why are you waving your finger? Who was it who shouted?" "I was walking along here, not interfering with anyone, Your Honor," Ryukin begins, cuffing into his fist. "I was talking about firewood to Mitri Mitrich when this low brute, for no rhyme or reason, bit my finger. You must excuse me, I am a working man. Mine is fine work. I must have damages, for I shan't be able to use this finger for a week, maybe. It's not even the law, Your Honor, that you should put up with it from a beast. If everyone is going to be bitten, life won't be worth living." "Very good," says Otomailov sternly, cuffing and raising his eyebrows. "Very good. Whose dog is it? I won't let this pass. I'll teach them to let their dogs run all over the place. It's time these gentry were looked after. if they won't obey the regulations. When he finds the blackguard, I'll teach him what it means to keep dogs and such stray cattle. I'll give him a lesson. Yalrin, cries the superintendent, addressing the policeman. Find out whose dog this is and drop a report. And the dog must be strangled without delay. It's sure to be mad. Whose dog is it, I ask? I fancy it's General Zigalov's, says someone in the crowd. General Zigalov's? Help me off with my coat, Yeldrin. It's frightfully hot. It must be a sign of rain. There's one thing I can't make out. How it came to bite you? Ochumailo turns to Ryokin. Surely it couldn't reach your finger. It's a little dog and you are a great hulking fellow. You must have scratched your finger with a nail. And then the idea struck you to get damages for it. We all know your sort. I know you devils. He put a cigarette in her face, Your Honor, for a joke, and she had the sense to snap at him. He is a nonsensical fellow, Your Honor. That's a lie, Squinty. Were you enjoying the story? But students, we have to stop here. We have to analyze whatever we have studied. And if you are curious to know what happened next, then that means the purpose has been accomplished. It aroused curiosity in you to know what happened next. But stop, let's analyze. So these are the main characters of the story. Ochumailov is a police superintendent, Ryokin a goldsmith, General Zigalov, although this person doesn't appear in the story, but his name is repeated and in the next part of the story it will again be mentioned. So he also is an important character. Yeldrin is a red-haired policeman. Then there is mention of Mistimitrich. Then the place where the story occurred is Pichugin's timber yard. Now, let's study what was in the story. Ochumailov, a police superintendent in the story, is walking across the market square. He was wearing a new overcoat. He carries a parcel under his arm. Yeldrin, a red-haired policeman, walks after him with a sieve full of gooseberries. Suddenly, he hears a man shouting and the painful cries of a dog. It is jumping on her three legs. A man is chasing her and falls. He catches the dog by its hind legs. He sees a man in a starched cotton shirt with his unbuttoned waistcoat. Ochumailov recognizes him. He is Ryokin, the goldsmith. Soon people gather around Pichugin's timber yard. Ryokin, the goldsmith, shows his right hand's bleeding finger. He charges that the dog has bitten him. He has to do very delicate work. But now, he cannot work for a week. He wants compensation from the owner of the dog. It is unlawful to leave the dog unchained. The dog in the crowd has an expression of terror and misery in her fearful eyes. The police superintendent takes a serious note of it. He speaks that rules and regulations must be obeyed. He instructs Yeldrin, the policeman, to draw a report. He threatens to teach a lesson to the owner of the dog and declares that the dog should be strangled. At the same time, a voice from the crowd says that it is the dog of General Zigalov. On hearing this, the harsh tone of the police superintendent softens. That's why we called him a chameleon. He becomes uncomfortable. He asks Yeldrin to help him take off his coat. He starts blaming and accusing Ryokin. He tells Ryokin that it is a little dog and he is a great hulking fellow. He pleads how a small puppy can bite Ryokin's finger. Squintai from the crowd says that he troubled the dog with his cigarette. And in the next part of the story, we will see how again the police superintendent will change his stand. But before we move on, we have to do a small exercise. Students, you can see some sentences on the screen. You have to fill in the blanks with suitable options. You have just read the story and also the summary. Please fill in the blanks. A red-haired policeman walks after him with a sieve full of dash in his hands. Yeldrin was a dash. Dash was chasing the dog. Ryokin raised his dash hand. And I am sure you have answered all these correctly. Let's check the answers. The first answer is gooseberries. Then policeman. Ryokin and Wright. Let's answer some questions. You have to answer them in one word or one line. Where was the police superintendent Ochumailov walking? What was he carrying under his arm? Who was walking after him? What was the red-haired policeman carrying in his hands? Please write the answers in your notebooks. Let's see what the answers are. The police superintendent Ochumailov was walking across the market square. What was he carrying under his arm? He was carrying a parcel under his arm. Who was walking after him? Yeldrin, a red-haired policeman, was walking after him. If you write only Yeldrin was walking after him, then also your answer is correct. What was the red-haired policeman carrying in his hands? The red-haired policeman was carrying a sieve full of gooseberries in his hand. Next question is, who was chasing the dog? Why was he chasing the dog? What was Ryokin wearing? Please write the answers. I hope you have written the answers. Who was chasing the dog? Ryokin was chasing the dog. Why was he chasing the dog? Ryokin was chasing the dog because the dog had bitten his finger and it was bleeding. What was Ryokin wearing? Ryokin was wearing a starched cotton shirt with the waistcoat unbuttoned. The next question is, what did Ryokin display to the crowd? How was Ryokin's bleeding finger a flag of victory? Why did Ryokin think that he must have damages? Please write the answers in your copy. I hope you have written the answers. What did Ryokin display to the crowd? Ryokin displayed his bleeding finger to the crowd. How was Ryokin's bleeding finger a flag of victory? Ryokin's bleeding finger was a flag of victory because the law was on his side. A stray dog was not allowed to move freely. Why did Ryokin think that he must have damages? Ryokin thought that he must be compensated because of his bitten finger. He will have to stay without work for a week. So students, I hope you were able to answer all the questions. So we have done half of the story. The rest half we'll be doing in the next lesson. But before we finish off today's session, let's revise once again. The story is chameleon. Chameleon means a person who changes his attitude, who changes his behavior according to the situation. How Ryokin changed his behavior? You noticed in the beginning when Ryokin complained to him that his finger has been bitten, he complained about the dog. What was Ochumailov's stand? Ochumailov's stand ki si? He was sympathetic. And he ordered that the dog must be strangled. Ki isno khatam kar do. Kill the dog. So he was sympathetic towards Ryokin. But the moment he came to know that the dog belonged to General Zhigalov, he changed his behavior. Now he was against Ryokin. That's why we called him a chameleon. He changed. So in the next part of the story, we'll see that the same person will change his behavior again and again. So for now, we have to read the story at home, go through the story, try to enjoy it. This is Varinder Kaur Sekho, lecturer in English, Government Senior Secondary School, Machli Kalan, Mohali, who prepared this presentation with the help of Jagriti Gaur, also lecturer in English, Patiala. So students, I hope you enjoyed the story, and if I have been able to arouse curiosity in you to know what will happen next, then that means my purpose is solved. Thank you so much. Enjoy.